Hello friends, welcome back to ProHut IT Services. Good to see you back. In this video, we'll learn the steps of installing and configuring DHCP Server on Windows Server 2012 R2. To install DHCP, click on Server Manager, click on Manage, select Add roles and features. Selecting add roles and features will start a wizard. On the add roles and feature wizard, click on next. On the select installation type window, we can see two options. First, role based or feature based installation. Second, remote desktop services installation. Second option is for VDI, which is out of scope for this video, therefore we are not talking about this. Let's select the first option, that is role based or feature based installation, and click on next. In Windows Server 2012, we have an option to remotely install roles and features. On the select destination server, select the server on which you want to install DHCP role and click on next. On select server roles, select the role that you wish to install. Scope of this video is to install DHCP, therefore we'll select DHCP server role. Click on add features. It will install all the features on which DHCP is dependent. On select features window, we don't need to select any feature. As in the last window, we have already selected the features. But if you still want to select any additional feature, then you can select that and then click on next. Click on next. On confirm installation selection window, it shows all the roles and features that we have selected to install. You can select restart the destination server automatically if required. It will restart the server automatically if role requires the server to restart. Don't check this option if you don't want to restart your server automatically and you wish to restart your server manually. Click on install to start installation of DHCP server. As the installation is going to take a while, I'll pause the video and will be back once the installation is completed. As we can see that installation is completed successfully, now we can start configuring DHCP. To configure DHCP, click on Complete DHCP Configuration. On the DHCP Post-Installation Configuration Wizard, it gives an information to create security groups for delegation of DHCP server admin rights. Click next, as delegation of DHCP is out of scope for this video, therefore we are not creating any security groups. In a domain joined environment, only after DHCP is authorized, it will start serving DHCP client requests. Authorization of DHCP server can only be performed by a domain user that has permissions to create objects in the net services container in Active Directory. You must be a member of administrators group or the DHCP administrators group to administer DHCP server. In addition, only members of domain admin groups can authorize or unauthorize a DHCP server in Active Directory. You need to specify credentials of domain admin and then click on commit. On the summary window, it confirms that post-installation configuration steps are completed and DHCP server is authorized. Click on close to close the wizard. Click on close. With this, we are done with the installation of DHCP server on Windows Server 2012 R2. In the next video, we'll learn the steps of configuring DHCP server. Till then, bye, keep smiling, have fun.